Hello everyone, and welcome to Java Basics. In this video, we will learn about three important concepts: variables, fields, and methods. Last time around, we created the initial Hello World application that we see here. Let's start by placing the mouse to the right of the curly braces here and clicking. This will move the cursor to this location. Once that happens, we can press Enter. This creates a new line and places the cursor there. Notice that the cursor isn't in the start of the new line. It's a bit deeper and aligned to the word system below it. This is called indentation. We don't need it for the program to work, but it's important for readability, so try to preserve it. It helps us differentiate the different scopes that we're looking at. Currently, we're in the method scope, so we've got two levels of indentation. The method itself is in the class scope, so it has one level of indentation. Next, I type the word string. String is a class name and stands for a basic declaration. Since Java is case sensitive, it's important to start with an uppercase S and the rest as lowercase. Notice that the IDE pops a completion dialog. It tries to guess what I want to type as I type it. You can pick an entry from the completion dialog instead of typing the whole word. Now I need to come up with a name for the variable we're declaring. I'll use the name hello, which is just a name. It can be anything. We then use the equal sign and the value on the right-hand side, which I copied from below. I end the line, like every line in Java, with a semicolon. What we have here is a statement. In this statement, I take a value, which is the Hello World text you see on the right hand, and create a variable on the left-hand side to carry that value. Why is that useful? We can now use that variable instead of writing everything down. Instead of writing the string directly in the println call, I can pass the variable. Better yet, I can use string arithmetics to modify the variable and connect two strings together. We'll discuss doing math and using expressions more in the next couple of videos, but for now, this statement is pretty obvious. We can now press play and run the application. The expected result appears in the bottom left. It's Hello Shai. If you're following along, use your own name and get this to work. Let's talk about methods. We go to the finishing curly braces and press Enter. I want to create a completely new method. This is a private method since it's internal to the class. We don't need to access it outside of the class. This should be the default for everything you add. It needs to be static at the moment since I want to call this method from another static method. We'll discuss that more later. It's also void since it returns nothing. I give it the name sayHello. This name is just something I made up. Naming methods, variables, and classes is up to your imagination. But there are some limitations on characters that you can use and some conventions. I won't burden you with them at this moment. I cut the body of the main method and move it to the sayHello. Then I invoke the sayHello method from the main method. Why do that? Why not write everything in main? There are several reasons for that, but the most immediate and basic one is that it would be really hard to read. The more important one is reuse. We can invoke the method from many different places and reuse the functionality. Finally, I'll add a field. A field is a variable that's a part of the class. In this case, I will make it a static field since I need to access it from a static method. I will give it the string type and the name my name, since it literally represents my name. I will assign it the value Shai. Notice that I can assign and read values from fields just like I can do with regular variables. So when I construct the say hello string, I can use this field as part of the arithmetic instead of typing in my name. That means the different methods in the class can assign a different name to the field, and then say hello will say hello to that person. It's a pretty powerful concept since the field is private. It's only accessible by methods within this class. It's usually a best practice to keep fields private in Java. We covered a lot today, but I still barely touched the surface. In the next video, we'll discuss arguments, conditional statements, and arrays. We'll also learn a bit about debugging, which is an amazing learning tool. If you have any questions, please use the comment section. Thank you.